Meet the 17-year-old CEO behind a $12 million AI-powered nutrition app. That app is Cal AI. It's an AI app that allows users to scan their food and track their calories. It's been downloaded over a million times, and it was built by two teenagers. In this video, I'm going to break down three ideas that you can use to build something similar and potentially make millions of dollars. And I'm going to give you the tools that you need to build these apps, even if you don't know how to code. And if you stick around till the end, I'm going to reveal the marketing hack that Cal AI used to grow their app to millions of users. I'm about to reveal three business ideas that you can use AI APIs to build, and you can use vibe coding tools to actually create them. These are coming from my database of 59 validated AI business ideas, so click the link in the description to get the full list. The first app idea is called FitFitness. So the idea is that you would upload videos from your workouts, and then the AI would analyze the video and give you tips on form correction and essentially be your AI personal trainer. Similar to Cal AI, I would use the image, or in this case, video analysis AI model. So I recommend using the Gemini 2.5 Pro preview model, or they actually have it not in preview as well. You can get that through the API. But I recommend using this model because you can upload video to it. It can analyze video and return a result. And what I'll do is I'm just going to demonstrate what this looks like on the AI developer side. And then you can imagine all you'd have to do is package this up into an actual app that people could use. So to test this out, I'm just going to paste in a YouTube video of someone basically working out with bad form. And then I'm going to say, just using the video, not any of the audio, please describe how the form of the person working out could be better. So you want to make sure you're on 2.5 Pro preview. For now, we won't worry about anything else. I'm just going to run this prompt so you can see just what's possible using AI models. We can see the model is thinking here. It's going through. And here we go. We're getting really detailed feedback on the specific workouts that were being done. So here we can see the lat pull down. It's describing the bad form and telling us how to improve it. Same with the seated cable row and how to improve. Same with tricep pushdown and how to improve. So this is really impressive. And I could totally imagine an app that people would record themselves at the gym and get personalized AI fitness feedback on their form. And I think people would pay a lot for this. So how would I actually build this app? I would use a tool called RORK, RORK.app. And this is an app builder that is meant for building mobile apps. So while tools like Lovable and Bolt are meant more for web apps, this is meant for mobile apps, which I think would work best for this type of idea. So on to business idea number two. This is an AI financial planner. The idea is that we can connect all of the user's financial accounts, and you can do this through Plaid. So I'm going to tell you through this video how to actually build these with what integrations you would need. So Plaid is a platform that allows you to have users connect to any of their bank accounts securely and then bring their data into your app. So for example, they could bring their transaction data from their bank, from their credit card statements, things like that. So the idea with this app is that we would have an AI financial planner. We would bring all of their data into the app, and then we would have the AI model analyze that data and then give them recommendations, both allowing them to chat with their data and then maybe proactively, like every day or every week, we could have prompts to analyze the data and then proactively reach out to the user with tips on how to save money, different things like that. The business model here could either be paid, so users could pay, or you can do more of a free model where users use it for free, and then you can make money by recommending things like credit cards or other financial products like that, which generally have very high referral fees. To build this app, I would recommend starting with Lovable. The reason I recommend starting with Lovable is they do a really good job at integrating with third-party APIs. So I think Lovable would do a great job at integrating with Plaid and understanding the Plaid APIs and also with the AI models. I would recommend using OpenAI. They just released two new models in their API, O3 and O4 Mini. I would probably recommend O4 Mini. I find it to be really good at analyzing data. It's very powerful, and also it's quite affordable. It's actually less expensive than 4.0. It's a little confusing how they have 0.4 and 4.0, but Anyway, I would recommend using O4 Mini for this. I think it's a good balance between power and also affordability. So I would recommend using Lovable to build the MVP version of this app. So the final AI business idea that we're going to go over in this video is an AI app for sales teams. So the idea is that you would have an app, you could be installed on your iPhone that you could turn on during sales calls. So it could be on the side. It would take in the audio from the sales call. And we would use the OpenAI API for that. There's a speech-to-text API. So if you have the audio file, pass it into OpenAI, you can get back out a text file. Another platform that I recommend for this is AssemblyAI. It's really good as well for speech-to-text. So you could check out both of those. Assembly has some more advanced features for this, so it might be worth looking into, but I believe it's a little bit more expensive than OpenAI. Then it would be as simple as taking the transcripts from the call, running them through an AI model with some custom prompts, such as O4 Mini, like I said before. You'd want to test out different models to see what works best. You could also explore Anthropic, is another really good AI model provider. They have Claude. So Claude is just more expensive than OpenAI right now, and this is changing constantly. But if I were building it right now, I would probably use OpenAI to analyze the calls. And then you would give the user feedback on how they can improve their sales process and questions, and how do they close more clients essentially by being a better salesperson. I would sell this to businesses, B2B, directly to their sales teams that they could use both to help their sales teams improve, but then the sales leader or the manager could also very easily see all of the feedback from their team in one place. So I think this would be a really valuable tool. If I were building this, I would also use RORK. I think having it natively downloaded onto an iPhone would be really helpful because then you could just place it next to your computer and record your sales calls so that you could get all of that in one place really easily. So I would recommend using RORK and again, integrating with either OpenAI or AssemblyAI for the transcription. And then OpenAI for the analysis. So circling back to Cal AI, how did they get millions of users to download their app? You could follow my advice, build one of these business ideas, but if you can't actually get users, you're not going to make any money from it. So something else to remember is just because this worked for Cal AI doesn't mean it would work for every business idea. Every business is different, and different marketing channels are going to work differently depending on who your audience is. The specific tactics that they used, if we think about the business ideas that we went through in this video, I think the fitness AI coach that's going to take videos of yourself and give you form tips is probably the most similar to Cal AI, and I think this strategy could work for you with that idea as well. So what did Cal AI do? They invested heavily in influencer marketing. They also did paid marketing as well, but influencer marketing with viral content was the most important thing that they did to grow. And you can see they have videos here that have millions of views each. And it's just a very viral concept of being able to show visually the food being photographed and then seeing the calorie amount directly on there. And here's a video from a similar company. I can go back real quick. This is palpal.app, which is basically a clone of Cal AI. And you can see this is their influencer strategy or their TikTok strategy. I hope that you found this helpful. If you want 59 AI startup ideas that you can start building today, click the link in the description. You'll go to this page, enter your email, and you'll immediately get the business ideas. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more content like this for free, and leave a comment if you have any questions at all. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.